back on again, and this time I'm about to get some Divinity Original Sin going. Set up. And I'm gonna go ahead and start over and create another character. And yeah, I'm going with Tactician Honor Mode again. Just wasn't feeling right going choosing otherwise. Although, if I do fail this time around, I'll probably just go ahead and shift down the difficulty. Because, I mean, I'd kind of like to progress through the game, too. Oh, and also, for part of the stream, I'm going to have me some V8 energy drinks. And going to have a Reese's peanut butter egg. My store is carrying these now. That's fine. Loads and loads of loading.
As a general of the House of War, I, the Red Prince, was raised within the vast palaces of the fabled Forbidden City. I was destined to become the next emperor. But my ambitions suffered a bit of a setback when I fell from grace for cavorting with demons. Now, I'm exiled and hunted by assassins. But I assure you, I remain undaunted and as determined as ever to claim my rightful throne.
All right, so, and I don't really want a build preset. I figured out recently how to really make a custom character. course, on the downside, I don't want to be a freaking lizard. I don't want the extra crit chance. Huh?
I've been a performer, a musician, beloved and celebrated by all. But I have a secret. I'm also a playground for sprites and spirits and... worse. The voice that rings inside me now is darker than any that came before. Almost caused a bunch of my fans to rip each other to pieces. But you can trust me. I've got this under control. Find out who, or what, is trying to take control of my mind. Step two, make it sorry it ever tried.
I like spell song, but I don't want to be a lizard in order to get it though. So I guess I'll just pick cleric, or undead human. Guess I'll start here. Excuse me. Deal damage directly to vitality. Not sure. Thief, definitely. Oh, shoot. I don't think I can. Thought I'd be able to. Or I guess make kind of an assassin thief off of Baldur's Gate, and just focus on poison attacks. Yeah, I'm gonna have to back up. Excuse me. You better, I guess, make myself a dwarf. Now you can't get rid of those two talents. I wish you would, or I wish you could. Yeah, so it looks like I'm gonna have to go with a dwarf. So go with that. Yeah, I'll go with that one.
Better luck next time.
Better luck next time.
Oh, cool. I can start from scratch. Oh, never mind. Let's go. And yep, I'm starting over again. Creating a new character, and difficulty wise, I think I'm going back to Tactician Hunter. I think last session I shifted down the difficulty, but I couldn't do it. But what I'll go ahead and do though is if I fail again, then I'll go ahead and shift down the difficulty. Civil bill. And this time around, I'm gonna choose Scoundrel and Geomancer. Mainly because, extra poison damage. I'm gonna make this guy kinda like my assassin rogue on Baldur's Gate. So I can still only choose three. Okay, going on the browser. I'm gonna look this up, but There's a poison dart in here too. So, looks like, Geomancer's out of the question. Oh, like first aid. Okay, so probably what I'll just go ahead and do is I'll go through all these skills here and find out what kind of spells they give me. Okay. Ooh. So far, I'm lacking warfare. Okay, these are, intelligence. Like I said a few moments ago, just gonna go through all the skills and see what they do, or see what they give me. Definitely wouldn't be grabbing that one. Ew. like that. Makes you faster. Oh, that requires intelligence. Jane already looked at that. Necromancy. Oh, that one looks interesting. That's like the corpse explosion ability on Diablo 2. Gonna make up a vampire dwarf. Wrong one. And I think I've seen this one before. That's a 6-turn cooldown, though. Resist my magic armor. Let me look up atrophy real quick. Let's see what that does. Target can't use weapons or skills. Of course, resisted by physical armor. And I guess before I forget, let me check out if there's anything else I should know about backstabbing. so far, polymorph. But yet, I can only still use 3 skills. I already know that one. Sneaking and persuasion. Because there's going to be some situations that I've found so far that's going to require me to be able to talk my way out of a situation, so. Definitely going to need that. So basically what I've done is I just created a shadow blade. Crit chance, initiative. Yeah, so I'll just go with that. Gotta be lone wolf. Scoundrel, I think, yeah. To recovery. Okay, so I got that. Tags. Definitely Jester. Yes, I'll go with that. But it, man, go back up. Looks like I'm all set. And like I said earlier, I'm gonna go with Tactician honor mode. And if this fails, then I'll go ahead and shift down the difficulty. And if somebody wants me to go ahead and, wants me to skip this, let me know.
single drop of source magic. And, like flies to honey, the monsters swarmed. The rabble panicked. The carnage began. And the magisters pointed their fingers at me. Just as I'd planned. I was shackled and collared and sent to Fort Joy. I'd come here to kill Godwoken. But instead, I became part of their story.
Still a bit groggy, are we? Don't worry. The sedative will wear off soon enough. Easy now. No need to hurry. Get your bearings.
I guess. All right, I'll just go ahead and do this. Since I'm at a good stopping point right now, I'm gonna go ahead and break off here for about 5 or so minutes. Gonna use the bathroom, and then I'm gonna get me some, something to eat as well. Be right back. And one thing about this hardcore mode, you only have one save file, so there's no saves coming in this one.
Not a very chatty fellow, are you?
And if something like that happens, where an autosave kicks in, it overwrites your previous save. So, like I said, there's no saves coming in here. Oh, and I'm gonna have me some red wine vinaigrette salad. And I gotta have one, maybe both of these Reese's peanut butter eggs. Yes, they got those in now.
Did you expect a needle?
Not sure this is gonna work. Still might not be heavy enough. No, I did.
snort behind you.
Is my shift over? Wait, you're no magister. You're a sorcerer. What are you doing here, filthy dwarf? And it's about time, too. The lads and lasses up there are getting lazy. Figures they'd send one of you sorcerers down. They could barely be chuffed to wiggle a sick. Can't just leave the prisoner alone, though. I heard he might be the one causing trouble upstairs.
Uh-oh.
If it's all the same, I think it's best he comes with me. Some offense intended. Yep. Keep your hands where I can see.
Hurry up, soldier. We haven't all day.
No.
I'm guessing that's a racial ability. Before I turn cooldown on it, though.
Dead magister. Somebody will have to take the blame for this.
Stroll.
And it won't be me.
So it looks like we're just going to be trading blows. for. I can't remember if there was a weapon in there or not. Be a knockdown, drag out battle. And I only have one potion. Sure. A critical hit when he only had 2 health points left. Totally forgot that was one upside of being undead. They can pick locks. There it is. Hey, found it. Nothing underneath it.
And I'm back where I started. Nowhere to go but up.
All right, up we go. Options. And apparently you can't change them. That'd be kind of cool to switch things around a little bit.
I hope. The collar, I mean. Oh, not to worry. Every dog has to get used to its leash. In the meantime, your next stop will be Magister William. All passengers have to be registered in the ship's manifest, and he's the chap in charge of the logs. You'll find him on the other side of this deck, in the officers' quarters. We're at sea, of course, and have been for several days.
Index fingers pressed to her lips. She pauses a moment to give you a scrutinizing gander.
My word, you do seem a bit befuddled, don't you? Perhaps I was a bit too generous with that sedative. Oh, well, I'm sure you'll soon gather your wits. Most likely. Eventually. A new life awaits, and if you're a particularly good boy, perhaps a cure as well. An end to sauce. Is he? Oh well. Some problems simply sort themselves, don't they?
Huh.
She frowns and peers at you closely, resting the back of one hand on your forehead and taking your pulse with the other.
Delusions such as these are rare, but not unheard of. I recommend a cup of mulled wine and another night's sleep. Just take it easy. Why, for my peace of mind, of course. Why don't you try casting one of those source spells of yours? Oh, do go on. I won't hold it against you. Promise. My, aren't we a neat little lamb? Perhaps I needn't have called you at all. Well, so let's just leave it on, shall we? Because to answer your question, what this collar does is for your own peace of mind, of course. Yours and the whole world.
Good gods! There's been a murder here.
Behind the Magister, a bloodied mass lies in a heap. Gore and limbs lie.
There's been a murder. A sorcerer was killed by one of your own. Lucky you were busy getting your collar fitted. Waters is investigating. She'll figure out who did it.
Aren't you enterprising? I'll go ahead. She with the body.
A young magister stands pale and silent. Her knuckles whiten around her weapon.
Bit of a nervous wreck, I'd say.
Ugly sight, isn't it? Burns me up this happened under our protection. We're extremely lucky no Voidwalker can follow the source that did this. Finn didn't see it like that. He was desperate for us to help him. Two things scared the living daylights out of. We'll find out who did this. Speaking of...
She looks up at you with a mirthless...
I was on duty in your room when the murder happened. You were asleep, though you're one of the only indisputably innocent people on the ship. Unless you can commit murder in your sleep, of course. Finn was killed by source. If a magister could, he looks more like a passenger, managed to slip their collar. Listen, I could use
nope.
A good living, and I'll throw in a shiny gold coin for you. How about that? A dwarf of principle. I get it. I wonder how you'll feel when whoever did this does it again. You let me know if you hear anything. Whoever... No known associates. In fact, he seems quite averse to spending time.
Gotta wait for her to turn around. Take that.
So, anything interesting for me? I'll take that as a no.
Okay, so excuse me. Huh?
I've seen more appetizing things coming out of the plague stricken pigs.
And I don't think you have to talk to any of these guys. I don't think. Oh wait, you need a greasy key. Let's try that. Nope.
They don't care about us. We're the cattle to them.
I'll give you that knuckle.
It's a register, sir. Good, good. Magister Williams is just about done with the last passenger. You faring okay so far? Glad to hear it. You head on in now. Williams will get you sorted fast.
Hell yeah, I'm scrounging, baby. I kinda wanna get to that box that's back there.
Standing at the center of the room, you spot a sorcerer haughtily eyeing a pair of nervous-looking magisters. They keep their crossbow trained upon her as she's being interrogated by an officer.
you admit it then? You murdered that poor fella.
Yes, I did. But of course, that was only the beginning.
She turns her head and looks you straight in the eye.
There are others whose lives must end.
Good God, the woman's mad. You there, sorcerer, go and fetch Magister Siwan. We need to do more to collar this maniac. We need to shackle her hands and feet.
It means your journey draws to a close. Do stick around for its finale, though, because...
She reaches for her collar and simply removes it.
I'm just about to create a scene.
Subdue her, men, quickly! If she casts source, the Void Worker will come.
She smiles with wicked satisfaction.
Precisely.
Boom!
What's happened?
Okay, I saw a restoration scroll over here.
Huh. 340.
Wish it would tell you how much it weighed. Why can't I pick a lock? So what did I do? Break my lockpick immediately? Yeah, apparently that's what happened. I already lost my damn lockpick. Oh, that kind of sucks. Maybe, but as far as I know, it's lockpicks are reusable, but there's a chance of breaking. Water balloon.
Not long before this thing snaps into splinters.
There it was. Now hopefully I can head back over here and unlock this door. Apparently not. Well, that's Mr. Book Reader.
Death fog press your palm against the door to open it. The wood feels neither good, it doesn't budge. The door groans open.
No. It's one hell of a package. Uh-oh. Maybe I should probably have brought a candle with me or something that has fire. Throw it at that spot of poison and that whole area blows up. I'm gonna wait for them to come to me. Ow! That's some piss poor pathfinding right there. One stinking health point. I'm already poisoned, so just go ahead and run that way. Wait. What, did that ability miss? And I guess my strength ain't high enough. Otherwise, I'd want to be able to carry off some of them water barrels up to the front of the ship and just start chucking them. Put out those fires over there. I want to try to get on that platform. Hey, wait, I got a water balloon. Captain's log. Ah,
master lies on the floor.
On one of my other, games, you're actually able to heal her. Stained pants. Oh, excuse me. Can't see.
I've faced worse.
What's the hit percentage? Getting a little fuckled on the RNG here. One stinking health point. gotta head back up. Okay, now I can do it.
She clutches her neck, trying to stem the bleeding of a gush. With jagged movements, she raises her blood, quickly soaks through. It's working. The pressure is stemming the flow of blood. Something within the ship snaps. The floorboards shudder. Siwan struggles to her feet, clinging to you tightly. The ship lets out a deep groan. Then...
there should be a cutscene here.
This is it.
Crunch.
Honorable d.o.s, we lost a ship sailing sorcerer prisoners to Fort Joy. We assume some escaped and broke their collars. Their vile magic lured the Voidwoken. All who were aboard are presumed dead. Yours faithfully into eternity, High Judge Orivan.
I'd like to think that I have brought one with me. Hopefully I got a crate. Gotta start storing stuff in there.
The child has a small mirror in his hand. He holds it up at angles, inspecting his eyes, his chin.
I'm not supposed to talk to dwarves.
The child considers your statement.
You're just a person. You're one of the smallest I've ever seen. Little people. Like me, you mean, I guess.
He pauses.
Are you a sorcerer? One of those guys that brings the bad void things here?
The child looks at you straight on, unafraid, searching your face. He looks.
I don't see any source on you or me. I guess they're wrong or crazy. No one cares where I go. They know I can't leave the island. It's nicer out here than inside, anyway. They're gone now. Their majesties took them already. I guess now. how they're cured. And maybe that he didn't die. Guess I am. But it's just normal to be scared. There isn't anywhere safe. You'll see.
Oh. Upcoming battle.
Voidwalk. Those are the same beasts that sank our ship. Damn, they made it to shore.
Could be game over. Feeling like crap right now.
Those things at bay. Drowned and eaten by a void wolf. I wonder in which order. Thank you.
So I guess we'll get him as a buddy.
You spot a strange lizard gazing over the water with a steady malcontent. Yes, you recognize him from the ship. The lizard turns about with the graceful ease of a dancer. Or a duel.
I did survive, yes. And chances are I wouldn't have you not returned. You have my gratitude.
Hand over heart, he salutes you with a bob of the head. More than a nod, though less than a bow.
Yes, I'm sure you've all the makings of a hero and all that. Let's not now then, if there's nothing further. I'm sure I don't mean to.
He sighs dramatically.
Tell me, what do you see when you cast your glance? Memories.
He looks out over the water.
As for myself, when I see continents dotted with mighty cities, and shimmering along the soft curve of the sea's horizon, I picture the palaces that formed my paradise. Of course, it's rather specific. Quite obviously, I'm musing over the very actual empire that I lost.
Suddenly, having all the air of being deeply offended, he stares at you with utter incredulity.
Well, don't just stand there gawking like an ape at an abacus. Or do you really mean to tell me you don't know who I am? The very same. I am the Red Prince. The all of course.
And I'm kind of skimming through this convo after having already gone through it twice already.
There's a brief moment's pause, during which his grandiloquent pose deflates ever so slightly.
That said, I suppose I must own up to the fact that I find myself rather in between. Grandeur that is my fate has hit a bit of a snap. Never you worry. The throne. Kind offer indeed. And you find, I act on one for reasons I'll not disclose. I've reason to believe one of them may be present on this island. Jolly good. So, now that that's said, even if you are as a born fighter, I prefer the perfection of the blade myself.
Yep.
And I'm well acquainted with the secrets of magic, and yes, very well. Onwards then.
The Red Prince nods.
Now, as you're aware, you'll be trapped. As your luck, of course, there are other.
The cat's eyes are clouded, its eyes clear. The cat's eyes, it appears confused.
I don't always want to talk.
Alright. Uh-oh. Something big's about to happen. No, I just need something that widens that radius. gonna stay away from that area for a while. Hidden area. What the? Accidentally attacked a cat.
The cat's eyes are clouded and gray. It appears confused.
And, yeah, that is one drawback to this game. Every object in here has an interaction panel. And, when two of them get close to each other, I'll often do that, end up targeting the wrong thing. What did you find? What, the crate?
I've spotted something.
Here lies a nameless inmate. May he find the peace denied him in life in the Hall of Echoes.
Cat, get out of there. Cat.
I don't have the right tool for digging.
Okay. Yeah, I think last time I played this, I found that too. Gonna go dig another man's grave.
One must put in due effort if one is to reap the proper reward.
Whoops. Might be end of the game right here. Oh, also, what my Twitch description says, I am playing on Tactician Honor Mode. So, last time I did this, I pretty much had to quit and start over because I provoked an unwinnable battle. So, in a situation like that, I just as soon as start over. The battle was in Fort Joy, one of the quests. Either you had to give up a name of the thief, Or you end up having a fight. But think if it was with that battle there, all of their stats are really high up, and they all have a bunch of abilities and whatnot, whereas I hardly have anything, so. I'm not sure to access. Well, like picking a lock or something. Yeah.
Oh my god. Okay. I'm just gonna, when this game ends, I'm just gonna go ahead and knock down the difficulty. And also for those that don't know, I am for the most part playing this blind. I think this is going to cause an explosion right here too. Yeah, but like I said, my default, typically, when I get a chance in any game I play, I prefer to play hardcore, or permadeath, especially true when I'm brand new to the game. Probably not going to get that far anyway, so that'd be about as good a time to do that as any. Now, if I was playing hardcore and I was way into the story, like maybe towards the final boss, and if I thought I was about to die, I mean, I'd probably figure out a way around it or a way to get through it. But I mean, I'm at the start of the game, so I'm gonna be fairly quick to just start over. Anyway, I'm babbling right now. So. Oh, and you leveled up. Too bad I can't build another wooden cross right here. So, can you interact with that spear? I don't really want to have to go through the whole inventory Olympics of transferring freaking everything over here into my other guy. Unless toggle multi-select. Oh, okay. There we go. Very awesome on the part of the devs to have done this. Or maybe not. Oh, God. All right. Just on the fact that I don't want to have to sit there and go through all that inventory crap. Just gonna go ahead and start over. But like I said earlier, This is a blind run. This is my first time ever playing this game, so. I would actually hope that, but I haven't played through this entire game at all, so I don't, this is coming from, take out that what you will, but oftentimes I prefer they don't make a sequel. I mean, if I like this, really, really like this game, if I play through the entire game and I really like it, I'd actually hope they don't, because it'd be almost like they're trying to improve on perfection. One game that definitely comes to mind is a Darkest Dungeon. It's one of the few games I can think of where I actually only care for the vanilla version. Like, I don't like any of the DLC. Never played Darkest Dungeon 2, but I can't see that game being any better than the first Darkest Dungeon. But like I said a few moments ago, I actually don't want any of the DLC on Darkest Dungeon. I only want the vanilla version. It's that damn good. So, yep. Starting over. And this time, I'm gonna go ahead and go with Classic. I mean, again, I'm a huge fan of hardcore mode, but then again, I would like to be able to progress through the story some. Oh, and the add-on that I'm using is Sprint. Just allows me to move faster. And now, unless achievements like give you gold and or XP, I don't really care about them. It might end up having to be a dwarf. I want to have a talent point in there. I do want to listen to this guy's story, though.
Justified imprisonment, I found them gone. Our culture forgotten. Any trace of the world I knew all but obliterated. I must even hide my true face beneath an ever-shifting mask for fear you savages will attack me. That is how I wander this strange world. Trying to uncover the truth about a history you primitive people never even knew existed.
And, this is kind of nitpicky, but you know, I wish the devs, whenever they create undead, like skeletons that talk, would put something in there about speaking telepathically, or magically speaking or something like that. But I can't recall a single game where they do that, because otherwise, how the hell can they talk normally? I mean, they have no voice box, you know, they have no mouth, no jaw muscles, they have no tongue. I mean, so technically,
I mean, that would be at best. I mean, then without a voice box, all it would be is... So, but again, it's kind of a little nitpick, but... But I'd like to set it up so that I have two civil abilities. It seems persuasion is practically a requirement. Because I'll probably most likely play a rogue again. Just like Baldur's Gate, I tend to like the thief class a lot because they're so versatile. You know, picking locks, picking pockets. You know, stealing stuff that costs a whole metric ton of money otherwise, that would require me to do a whole shit ton of grinding. I don't want the crit. And another good thing about undead is they automatically have the lockpicking ability using their little bony finger. But see, none of these give you extra skill points. Yeah. I guess I'll go with a human. Some cool looking skulls, though. Oh, it looks like he took an axe to the face. I'll most likely go with that one, though. There's like another one here. I don't know what happened to him. Looks like his head was carved in stone or something. Looks like it took a mallet to the side of the head or something. Yeah, that's something else that's pretty cool, too. Something I've never seen in any other game. They're sticking gems in their skulls. I guess this here is kind of a drawback too, although it's just a little one. I mean, that's like, looks off. I can't find the right words, but I would like to have seen the entire skull looking like that, not just select parts.
probably go with that and just say somebody dumped a whole bunch of lava on top of him. That's why he looks like that. It'd also be kind of nice if they just named the hair colors actual colors and not Cooper, Butcher, Baker, Candlestick Maker. Guess that one.
Nice try.
Better luck next time.
I think it was that. If anything, probably Necromancer. Then I basically would have just created a witch. Not quite yet. Not quite yet, Skull. So I'll... But, even with a sneaking rating of 0, I think you can still sneak. Just not as effective, so I'll go ahead and set that to 0. But, persuasion, I gotta have. Because I'll probably be doing the same thing in this game here that I've been doing in the past ones. I'll probably be spending a good chunk of my time, stealing from people. Or stealing stuff, so I'll need that persuasion to help me get out of those situations where I'm caught. Like always, picking Lone Wolf, picking Jester. Yes, Now, to make this clear, in real life, I am nothing like this. Like, I won't steal from anybody. I don't believe in robbing anybody or anything like that, but, part of it is kind of fun just picking pockets and, you know. But another part of it, too, is opportunity. Most every other game that I played over the years that have a thief class is nothing more than just somebody that does dexterity-based damage. That's it. You know, most of those games, you can't pick locks. You can't set or disarm traps. You can't steal from shops. It's like all... If this makes any sense at all they are the ones that deal the green damage. That's it. You know, the warrior deals the red damage. The rogue deals the green damage. The mage deals the blue damage. So it's always a good thing when I can get into a game like this where they have a thief class that is actually a fucking thief. I mean, that's what a thief does, steal stuff. And not just chucks daggers and does stabby, 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 like most other games. So, now that I got those extra attribute points, thinking about putting it in strength. But, there's also going to be a few situations in here where you might have to do strength persuasion. So it's always going to be good having that in there. It looks like I'm good to go, though. Okay, and again, to let everybody know, I'm really not doing this difficulty by choice. My default preference is hardcore, but the hardcore in this game is actually too good. Like, I can't hardly get anywhere. So, I kind of want to progress through the game, so I shifted down to Classic. Classic is the default difficulty. It also means I can, I believe I can save Scum now.
The rebel panicked. The carnage began. Magisters pointed their fingers at me. Just as I'd planned. I was shackled and collared. And sent to Fort Joy. I'd come here to kill Godwoken. But instead, I became part of their story.
easy now.
Just skipping it. Actually, I'll go ahead and pick that up. Pick that up too. That's where I'm gonna store all my stuff. Sheep to the slaughter. Oh, now it's immune to poison. Let me find a candle or something. Hopefully that poison doesn't disappear anytime soon.
Get me out of this cage and I'll make it worth your while. You in? A gentleman among jesters you are. Give that lever a pull and I guarantee we'll both get something out of the deal. Your guess is as good as mine. Someone screamed loud as a banshee. After that, pure pandemonium. They never even told me what I was accused of.
before you can even touch the loot.
Right, you, my Magister. You're a sorcerer. What are you doing here, filthy?
There we go.
And it's about time, too. The lads, I can't just leave the prisoner alone, though. I heard he might be. That's all I needed to hear.
Wait for him to leave.
The prisoner's buoyant voice darkens as his gaze finds the sunken hollows that once held your eyes.
Ah, freedom. Tastes better than wine. I'm nothing if not a man of my word. And I did give my word I'd set you free.
Here we go. Get him out of there. Actually trying to run away. Guess maybe find some stuff to throw at him. Huh? There's something else I can do. Close the door. And then... Lock the door. See you get through there, buddy. Well, apparently that didn't work. Figured I would bar the door and keep him from getting through. Because otherwise this fight's going to take forever. Yeah, and it'll be one that I've never played before either. Quite work that way. You know, it also doesn't really seem right that we're like a level one characters here, but yet we're sitting here doing spinning back kicks and hoo-yah, hoo-yah, like we're all martial artists. It should just be, you know, straight punches and stuff. Nice, he critically hits for 1 point. I'll go back in the jail cell area, see if there's anything there I can grab. Interesting in there.
So now I gotta find Mr. Magister guy. He was the one that had the lab key. No, that's right, I'm putting persuasion. Still can't steal stuff.
There you are. Not too tight. In the meantime, you'll find him on the other side of this deck. And don't you dare.
Index fingers pressed.
My word. Oh, well, I'm sure a new life awaits. And if you're a petite, is he? Why, for my peace of mind, of course. Why, do go on.
Currents of magic, sir.
You better stop before. There you have it. See? The collar's function. It for your own peace of mind.
All right, gonna head back downstairs. Let me find that up. Candle, where are you? No, because I probably dropped it on the way down to the lower floor here. So much for that.
And you've been told why. There really is no need.
Good gods. There's been a murder here.
Ugly sight, isn't it?
Burns me up this happened under our protection.
Finn didn't see it. We'll find out.
She looks up.
I was on. You're one of the only indisputably innocent people. Finn was killed by. It looks more like. Listen, bring me a good lead. I'll throw in a shiny. A man of principle. You let me know if you.
Gotta wait for her to move. Nice. Leave.
real quick, I'm gonna go get me something to eat real fast. I'll be back. And I'm gonna clean out my bowl as well. Okay, it's gonna be a bit longer. I'm gonna go ahead and actually cook some beans. Just feeling a bit hungrier than I anticipated, but I'll be back. Oh, also, I'm gonna go grab my cell phone as well, because it looks like my tablet is down to, the battery is down to like 25%, so I'll have to grab that as well.
And oh, forgot to grab my cell phone. I'll be back. He's back. Yet. I'm gonna go ahead and just I'm gonna swap out my tablet and cell phone now. Since I'm up and everything. Come on, shut off. And what other upside of using a cell phone? It is. On the downside, though, I'm getting burnt out on them from eating them so much. So, because of that, I've been starting to cheat a lot more. And some more retardedness. I gotta go grab my fork. I'll be back. Shut the light off. Forgetting many things at once. I think this is probably the first stage of Alzheimer's. Pretty soon, I'll forget to bring my head. Another upside of having myself using a cell phone, it's so small. I could just set it right here next to my microphone and not have, unlike my tablet where I have to set it over here because it's so big.
Listen. hatch is blocked. I'll need to find another way.
To register, sir. You faring okay so far? Glad to hear you head on in.
Now somebody don't like the food over there.
Center of the room, you spot a sorcerer haughtily eyeing a pair of nervous-looking magisters. They keep their crossbow trained upon her as she's being interrogated by an officer.
So you admit it then? You murdered that poor fella?
Yes, I did. But of course, that was only the beginning.
She turns her head and looks you straight in the eye.
Uh-oh. Guess I'm next.
Others whose lives must end.
Good God, the woman's mad. You there, sorcerer, go and fetch Magister Siwan. We need to do more than collar this maniac. We need to shackle her hands and feet.
No, I'm afraid I always perform my part solo. Do stay and watch, though, because...
She reaches for her collar and simply removes it.
I'm just about to create a scene.
Subdue her, men, quickly! If she casts source, the void won't come. They'll end us all.
She smiles with wicked satisfaction.
Precisely.
Boom!
What? What's happened?
Nothing left to her.
Before this thing snaps into splinters. God damn it. Need to get off this wreck and quick.
I'll take that. I think there was a YouTube video out there that said the nails are actually very valuable, very useful.
Great gods. Something's pounding on the hull.
Dirty socks. Some cheesecloth, huh?
The collar circling your neck and reaches a hand towards his blade.
Another sorcerer! Like you don't know? Mutiny! Did that witch fix your collar too? Go! Do what you must.
Bishop Alexander, if Lucian were alive, what would he think of his son's divine order?
And I think I might be shutting down here fairly soon. Starting to feel like crap, even though I really shouldn't be. Got a full day of sleep.
Just leave me be. Get off.
And you thought Rivelon was flat.
Unlocked using your bony fingers. Really?
Hmm.
That's what I was waiting for. Just gotta wait for him to come to me. Lumpy giblets.
So much for a peaceful.
There's the lab key. Carry it. Yeah. Duck you. Chloroform this guy. Come on, stop it. Jay, put him to sleep. No, actually, I'm off tonight, but, on Monday night, Tuesday morning, there's a chance, but usually a small chance that I might be streaming in the morning, but like I said, it usually doesn't, as of recent, it doesn't always work that way. I think, Monday's become more of my free day, but, Tuesday night slash Wednesday morning, or I should say Wednesday morning, I usually stream pinball at that time. But on Monday night slash Tuesday morning is also when I have to do my Monday blog post. Like, actually have to get it posted up on the Lodestone, on the Final Fantasy 14 Lodestone. So I'm still gonna be up pretty busy most of the night trying to get that going. And it's gonna be my final copy. It's gonna be the one that I actually upload. Usually every other day, I always try to at least get a rough draft going, because I don't blog every day now. I only blog like 3 days a week. But I'm still recording stuff on the days that I'm not doing that. So. You're wasting abilities, honey. That's some real stupid AI there. Here, let's throw an AoE firebomb, even though one of my allies is also in the area. I still think probably the best video game AI I've ever seen was probably Final Fantasy Tactics. Man, that's the kind of AI you can learn from. Yeah, so I'm drinking energy drinks, but it's not helping much. Final Fantasy Tactics, it's, as the name kind of implies, it's a tactical RPG, which, the AI on that is really good. More often than not, I don't even actually play the game myself. You can set all of your characters on autopilot, and they'll just make the decisions on their own. But yeah, like I said, the AI on there is really good. You know, like, if your target is immune to earth damage, I mean, your AI is not going to sit there and keep casting quake and earth spells on it. You know, it doesn't do anything stupid like that. It's, how do I explain it? I think it's so good, it makes your, it makes casting, various immunity abilities pointless. If the AI is that good, because if you cast, say, what would be an ability? Like an ability called Protect, which reduces your physical damage by some odd percentage. The AI, they'll just start casting magic spells on you. Knowing that you have protection on you, it'll just start casting magic on you instead if it can. You know, and then vice versa. If you cast an ability called Shell on you that reduces your magic damage, then the AI will just start doing physical attacks on you. Whereas most every other game I played, the AI basically consists of just one trick ponies. Only one mode of attack, only one method. Raw lumpy giblets. Okay, but I rescued all of them. Oh, there's a magister here. I gotta rescue her too. Kiwan's not an evil bitch, she's just doing her job.
Blood quickly soaks through the cloth. Magister Siwan's mouth opens and it's working. The pressure is something within the ship. Snaps. The floorboard shut. Siwan struggles to her feet, clinging to you tight.
Big old boy. That's a void woke and that's woke as fuck.
I have plans for you, child. Right.
Honorable Dallas, we lost a ship sailing sorcerer prisoners to Fort Joy. We assume some escaped. And broke their collars. Their vile magic lured the Voidwook. All who were aboard are presumed dead. Yours faithfully into eternity, High Judge Orivan. Those are the same beasts that sank our ship. Damn, they made it to shore.
Well, he sure woke up quick.
Drowned and eaten by a void worker.
weighs 5 pounds. Rescue this guy.
You spot a strange. Yes, you recognize him. The lizard turned.
I did survive. You have
hand over heart. He salutes.
Yes, I'm sure. Now then, if there's nothing further, if you really must know, I haven't quite.
He sounds.
Tell me, what do you see when you come? Memories.
He looks out at.
As for my, I see continents dotted with mighty cities, and shimmering along the soft.
Of course, he suddenly.
Well, don't just stand there gawking like an ape at an abacus. Well, more's the damn pit where I am the red.
Of course, you. There's a brief moment's.
That said, grandeur that is my fate has.
True.
Fine. On one. For reasons, I've reason to.
Jolly good.
Living impaired.
The undead. Like your goods. Come now, did you really think a handful of linen towels can fool me?
Well, I don't know, I'm assuming. I don't know, it seems to fool a lot of other people. I don't see why it'd be any different for him. I'm gonna put the rest of my beans in the fridge before I wind up eating the whole damn can. I'll be back. I forgot. Gotta have me a nanner.
Don't worry. I have studied the arcane arts for years, including necromancy and demonology. I do not hold the petty prejudices of common folks. In fact, I prefer the exceptional in all things. Your secret is safe with me.
Oh.
So, now that that's settled, first things first. Even if you are as versed in the art. As a born fighter, very well. Onwards
the Red Prince nods and gives you a smile.
Now, as you're aware, as your luck, of course, there are other forms of protein.
No, sir.
The cat's eyes are clouded, its eyes.
Found a shovel. Way out here? Cat, get out of there.
to a skeleton unlike any you have ever seen before. His skull seems to be approaching. You hear a profane mutter.
How on earth am I supposed to...
Skeletal fingers reached out and gripped the skin.
Damnation. That stuck fast. I wonder, does the beard act as...
No!
Actually, you don't seem half as threatening as those creatures in red. Run along, won't you? I have business. Why, its face, of course. A face that seems rather...
I would normally employ a tool to delicately, but viciously, rip the face from the body.
Okay. I could then craft a mask to hide my bone.
The skeleton grabs the corpse by the cheeks and pulls hard, grunting in frustration as the body's skin...
Carved? Please. You hardly think I am one of your breed, do you? You have never seen anything like it because you have never met anyone like me. Simply put, I am an eternal, and you are not. You have my sympathies. Indeed, no one seems to have the good taste to be. My people,
at least from this realm. As for the others...
A cult? Hardly. I could ask. We studied the mysteries, but I will find them.
I've read this before.
Wherever they are, I will find them.
So it... I'm just gonna go through quick.
Well, that is the... Every one of your race, perhaps my people have...
Regardless, they are not here.
Well, that hardly seems... Several centuries... I was sealed, and perhaps I should thank him. Yes, yes. Do for... By which I mean shout.
Spotted something.
Ow! Hello? Why won't you target the corpse? Think we leveled up. So now I can pickpocket people. So he's all set. Alright, because really, I don't have a second guy with me by choice, so, what I'm gonna go ahead and do is I might add another cheat, because like I said, the only reason why I got the second guy here is to be nothing more than a distraction. So what I'm gonna do here, Larian modification. So what this basically means, if I'm understanding this correctly, everybody's gonna get pulled together. But again, the only reason why I'm having this is because I ideally wanna play this game solo. So having an extra companion in there is not by choice. So I don't wanna have to sit here and constantly switch to my second guy to do all the bartering or have him doing all the conversation and whatnot. So, I'm going to go ahead and just set hagglers. It's just going to make things a lot easier. Oh, shoot. I saved and reloaded. Once I unlock the waypoint in Fort Joy, I'll probably shut down after that.
Here lies a nameless inmate. May he find the peace denied him in life in the
tooth. Okay, let's just hear.
Mister, I'm so glad you went back.
Uh-oh. Something about to happen.
I mean, let's stay back, Susan, and stay. Our god opens gates.
We know you've been helping sorcerers escape, Latusa. We have proof.
I'd sooner cut my tongue out than lie to you, Alexander. I know nothing of any escapees.
If you can tell the god woken no more, your tongue is of no use. Cut it out.
This can't be serious, Alexander. Come.
You should know by now to obey your superior, Magister. Whatever she may ask.
Natusa pinches the tip of her tongue with two fingers and brings her dagger to...
Stop! My father! May his soul rest in the fate of our realm, Dallas.
Yes, your holiness.
I believe we're done here.
Boom! She's gonna be taking a permanent vacation all over Fort Joy.
Come. You'll be needed elsewhere.
The lizard magister, or what's left of her, lies in a puddle of gore.
She was a lizard, yet a magister. No matter her reasons, her penalty was fair. Yes, by all means, let us partake in the art of conversation.
Damn. Okay, that's gonna do it for me, guys. I'm gonna go ahead and shut her down. Like I said, I'm feeling like crap right now. And plus, I still have a blog post I have to get put up. So I still got a lot of cutting and pasting and so on and whatnot. Got a lot of prep work, so. And plus, I gotta probably lay down for like an hour or two, at least. And like always, there's gonna be a small chance on my stream tomorrow morning. I'm thinking if I do, I want to say Final Fantasy 14, but we'll see. It's for the most part up in the air, so. But if I'm on, it'll probably be around 2:30 a.m. my time, U.S. Central. So, but aside from that, though, hey, thanks a lot for dropping in and hanging out with me, everybody. I appreciate that, and If I'm not on tomorrow morning, I should be on at my usual time, which would be around 4:30 p.m., also U.S. Central Time. And in all likelihood, it's probably going to be this game here, Divinity Original Sin, but there might be a small chance, too, that I might play something else. But like I said, it's not because I'm burning out on this game, it's mainly because I've got other games I want to play, too. But, and I'd like to give them a go. But, like I said, we'll see you come tomorrow. But, until then, thanks again for coming, everybody, and see you all next time. Oh, that's a pretty cool icon.